Someone wanted to ask about hybrid rockets. Hybrid not in the sense of solid with solid fuel with liquid oxidizer, or liquid fuel and solid oxidizer, as some of them are, but in terms of what's known as air-augmented rockets. If you're familiar with a ramjet is basically the same thing. In fact, what this is, in terms of an air-augmented rocket, they are also known as ram rockets. These are actually technologies that are actually used in missiles. The typical design is you have a solid rocket booster or a solid rocket motor. It can also be liquid. It can also be biprop. But it also has a cowl, an air intake that surrounds the exhaust, basically the nozzle of the rocket. And this air intake uses the supersonic fluid of the air coming in to further mix with the fuel-rich combustion of the rocket engine nozzle to add working mass to the ejected emissions to actually increase performance. When you scale this technology, it actually becomes incredibly hard, especially when you're talking about a rocket that is meant to be orbital. So to kind of back things up a little bit, how does this system work, right? You have your hybrid rocket or a solid rocket or biprop rocket, whatever it is, right? You have your rocket engine just like normal. And then you have this ramjet shroud. All it's meant is to take oncoming flow into this area here that is surrounding the rocket engine. What you have here, right, is you have your expanding gases, which is typically in this case going to be fuel rich, right? Fuel rich is typically what most engine exhaust is for a rocket. Why do you want it to be fuel rich? Because you have to understand that when you're using atmosphere, which is 20% oxygen, you have oxidizer coming in to this area. What you want to have happen is have your fuel-rich rocket exhaust mix with this oxygen-rich atmosphere and basically ignite itself, mix, get superheated, and then add that working fluid of the atmosphere for further expansion out of the rocket nozzle. On average, it will actually double the specific impulse of any rocket that it is used on, also increasing its effective thrust because you're adding the mass of the atmospheric particles to your expanding gases out of the rocket motor. This is actually something that is used on missiles. This is actually a paper done by the Air Force. They actually go around and show how they have used this air augmented system to get higher performance out of their engine. Basically, think of a ramjet, right? It's a simple jet, ramjet, or scramjet. Think like the SR-71's engine, right? Basically, it uses the massive compression that happens at supersonic and hypersonic flight of the air coming into the intake to compress those down, mix them with fuel-rich particles, combust it, and send it out the back, right? Basically a ramjet, but with a rocket instead of a jet engine, right? Pretty simple there. So this is interesting. It's actually used today, like I said, in missiles. Why is it not widely used? Because even though it has great performance and it is used on missiles, when you scale it up to orbital class rockets, that efficiency goes way down. For two reasons. One, in the flight regime where it would actually make the most effect, you're only in the atmosphere for a rocket for maybe the first 30 to 45 seconds in flight, where this would really, really take a lot of effect, right? Now, that's nothing to scoff at, because if you can double your ISP on the ground, then why wouldn't you still use it and maybe eject the cowl off the side? Well, again, you have to understand that where this really comes into effect is when you're going supersonic. Again, you don't stay in those regimes long enough because you're basically traveling up before you go over, right? So again, you would only get that supersonic compression for a very, very small amount of its overall flight time. And then you would have to add the complexity of then ejecting the cowl, because now that's an incredibly a lot amount of mass to have an entire shroud around your rocket. Think about having Falcon 9, right? That's 3.5 meter diameter core. That means that you would have to have a cowl that's bigger than 3.5 meter diameter of just mass that is only designed to take in the oncoming airflow and redirect it, right? So it's a 3.7, thank you. Yeah, 3.7 meter core. So that is an incredible amount of mass, especially depending on how long you need that cowl to be up and surrounding the rocket engines, right? Because look at this. I mean, if we're talking about a solid rocket motor being this big, this is just a rough sketch, right? If you're talking about your 3.7 meter core being here and then having an incredibly long ramjet cowl around those engines, That would be an incredible amount of mass. Third thing, heat transfer. When you're working with supersonic and now rocket exhaust, both the inside and outside have to be incredibly well protected against oncoming fluid dynamics, right? The compression, the superheated compression of all those air molecules being rammed into the actual ramjet intake, very hard to actually protect, especially when you're dealing with something that's going this fast and then also has to be ejected off the side because, well, mass, right? So that's a lot of complexity. And kind of like the last nail in the coffin with this thing, when you're working with ramjets, scramjets, whatever have you, like Bell nozzles, they are incredibly hard to design for efficiencies across multiple speeds and multiple altitudes. But that would mean that you would have to have your cowl actually move in one way, shape, or form. And now you're talking about adding just an immense amount of complexity, moving parts that has to separate because it's a lot of mass. It doesn't get a lot of efficiency because it's only being used for the first minute of flight. It's kind of like the last nail in the coffin. That's why it's not really typically used for orbital class rockets. Missiles, it works because missiles stay in the atmosphere, and typically missiles stay at one altitude. And yeah, that concludes the second episode of Main Engine Space.